this tutorial, we will use another editor of CDesign, the DEV editor, Default Values Editor. So we are talking about default values and more in general working with the parameters. Probably in the previous exercises you wondered why after uploaded the software into the controller the set points returns to zero rather than the previous value change in the mask, set in the mask or a default value like 12. So we are talking about this. Okay, it is a long topic, but believe me that at the end the system behaves as you expected. So how is possible to change or set the value to a variable? First option in CStrategy using the initial value properties, so this column. We have CStrategy, let's open the global or local variable. We can just make a couple of examples. So for example, for the set point, we will set the initial value to 11 and the differential proportional band to 3. So the initial value. Please note that the initial value is available for all variables of the application, not only retain or volatile or according to other properties. All variables may have an initial value. Second option in CDesign in the DEV editor. But before, it's better to save. So in CDesign, for a given configuration, the DEV editor. So here are the two values that we just set in CStrategy, and then we can give a default value. Again, please note that the user value, so in this editor, appears only the variables that are retained. So I can see set point and proportional band. I won't see, as you can see, the what in the temperature, because that is a volatile memory. So here you see only the variables that are in retain. And then by application. For example, we saw that we can change the set point in the mask. In the previous exercise, we also change via protocol, via Modbus master slave. So there are three ways. So what are the values that the system uses and when? The point is that at startup, before the application starts, all variables take a value that depends on the data type. In general, it's zero. So for all boolean, integer, real variables, the value is zero. After that, they take the initial value, if specified. After that, takes the DEV editor, also in this case, if specified. As I told you before, this is available only for the variable that are in retain memory. It is these three. So you will see here in the DEV editor, only the variables that are in retain. After that, the last value set by the application, for example, as told you before, in the mask, so if you change the set point in the mask, the next time that the controller restarts, it will take that value. Also, in this case, this works only for the retained variables. So, let's have some typical use cases. The first could be compressor 1. Compressor 1 has no initial value and also it is not retained. In this case, what happened? Startup, compressor 1 takes the value false, since it is boolean. False, then the initial value not specified, so remains false. DEV value is not the case because this is not retain, so remains false again. Last value set by application, also in this case it is available only for retain, so also in this case remains false. Second use case, set point. Okay, startup, it takes the value 0, after that the initial value that is 11, after that it takes the DEV value that is 12. So at this point, set point is 12. And then the last value set by the application, supposing that I have just uploaded this project into the controller, there is no last value, a previous value. So at this point, the set point will be 12. After that, let's suppose to change set point to 15, and then power off, power on, in this case 0, 11, 12, in this case there is a last value set by the application, that is 15, so the value will be restored and set point is 15, exactly as we expected. Power off, power on, set point as well as all other operating and configuration parameters takes the last value set by the application. Another use case, and this is a particular case, is when the project is different, that is, for example, the first time that I have uploaded the chiller alarms in the controller where was running the chiller project, that is the case, so the project is different. In that case, the system forces the DV editor, so what we've written here. So when the application is different, the system uploads automatically the default values. The same in case of wipe retain. It is possible to wipe the retain via system menu, as shown here. Enter the system menu, alarm enter for 2 seconds, application, wipe retain, enter. Later we will see this from live. As well as in the strategy using the syswrite function block, parameter 29, and so on. So when you clear, you wipe the retain memory, the system automatically install the default values. So probably now you are wondering, but why there are 2 sets of variables, of values, initial value and user value? Because since the initial value is available also for retain, I could always use this. That's right, but the difference is that these values are values set in the DEV editor, and the DEV editor is one of the sub configuration of a specific configuration. So these values are configuration dependent. That is, if you have 2 configurations, for example, save, if we create a new configuration, chiller compressors, I can have in the chiller for compressors a given set of default values where the set point, or maybe better, the proportional band is 4, while in the other configuration, the chiller 2 compressors, the proportional band is different, 2 degrees. So less compressors, I can use a smaller proportional band, as well as a different set point, and as well as different parameters. So the user values belongs to the configuration, while the initial value is common for all the configuration. So the initial value is something that is defined by the famous standard IEC 61131, while the DEV editor, the default values, is something that we have added to that standard. Well, now we can test our project in the real controller. My target is to test this particular case, that is, when the project is different, the system forces the default values, that is this one. So I have, just before start this part of the video, I have uploaded in the controller an old version of the chiller project. Now I'm uploading chiller alarms. So the system should detect that the project is different, so I expect the default values, set point 12 and proportional band 4. Okay, let's start to build everything, build strategy, build mask, I have to upload not the childer to compressors, but childer for compressors. Check again that the default are, yes, 12 and 4. Well, upload. Upload. So now expect that the set point and proportional band are 12 and 4. That's good. So they became 0, 11, 12, not yet changed, so it is 12. Now let's trigger the last one. Okay, even if we have seen this many, many times. So we have to change the value by application, protocol of application. So if I change the point to 12.3, and then I am powering off, and then power on, I expect set point back to 12.3. Controller is starting, and come on. I hope that the IP is still this one. I can try to refresh. Okay, now it should be okay. Here it is. I told you that I expect the last value, that is 12.3, and here is 12.3. So we tested also this part. Well, now we can try this part, or after a wipe retain. So now set point is 12.3, now I will try to wipe the retain, and I expect the set point back to the default value, that is 12. Okay, now is 12.3, I enter in the system menu, in the application, wipe retain. Attention that here there is no confirmation, so as soon as I press enter, it will wipe the retain. Now the project is restarting. Okay. Ask. I can press the bell also from here. And set point back to 12. So we have tested also this part. What's next? Next feature is this one, export and import parameters. Now we can see how to export import the values in the retain memory. This basically means save and restore the current configuration of the application. This because the configuration parameters like enable compressor 1, 2, 3, 4 and operating parameters like set point, differential, unit status and so on are saved in the retain memory. It is possible to export import using two specific function blocks called export params and import params. Well, they are two function blocks in the Karel Pico library. They have an input that defines the drive. The options are internal public flash memory or USB memory stick. Enable to write or also to read. Another one for the file name, path and file name. And there is also a return error code. Well, this project is based on the project template. The project template already have this implemented in the import export param. Here is an instance of the export param and the import param. We can specify the drive, internal or USB, the file name as a prefix, export underscore, and it is only possible to select the suffix, that is a number. But let's use it. So in the application, first of all, we can give some special number that are easy to remember, so 12.5 and 5, so 5.5, easy to remember. Okay, let's enter in the system menu, unit configuration, export or import. We start with export, memory type USB or internal memory, we start with USB. Here is the prefix export, let's select a suffix 5 and export. Okay, in the project template is let's say forbidden to export or import while the unit is on, so it is required to stop the unit off, try again unit configuration, again export, yes. Okay, cannot access disk, in fact the pen drive is not yet inserted, so I am plugging the pen drive. Let's wait a couple of seconds that it recognize it and try again. This is the right time. Export, yes. Cannot yet access disk. Okay, let's wait a second. Operation done. So now expect that in the pen drive there is a file called export5.txt. I'm removing the pen drive from the Pico. I plug it in the PC and here is export5. Here is the proportional band 5 and set point 12.5. Here I see 12.4999 because the variable is saved into a real data type, and maybe that you know that the real data type is subject to a precision in the numbers. Anyway, this basically means 12.5. Now we can try the opposite, that is to import the configuration. For example, we can change the proportional band to 2 and here the set point to 12.2. Okay, other two numbers, easy to remember, 2 and 2. Save back into the disk. I have to disconnect. Well, now I'm plugging again the key in the pen drive. This time I do the opposite, import. Same number, yes. Operation done, very good. So now expect that the set point is 12.2 and the proportional band is 2.0. Here is 12.2 and 2.0. So we have seen how to export, import the configuration. The same is available in the internal flash memory. This time I will try with 9. Operation done. So I expect now I'm connecting PC to the CPICO, and this is the internal memory of the controller. And here is export 9 with the last value that we have used. The last point is very important, in particular for who knows OneTool, because also OneTool has a sort of export-import parameters. The difference is that OneTool saves into the file not the variable name, but the variable address. And since the variable address can change every time you build the application, the exported file could be no longer compatible with the other versions. Here in C-Suite, the system uses the variable name. We saw right before that in the txt file, we see the name of the variable, setptemp, pbtemp, and so on. Therefore, the default values are not build dependent. This allows a couple of typical scenarios. The first is update the application in a given controller. So I can export the current configuration, upload the newer version, and import back the previous configuration. And this works. Another scenario is when I have to replace the controller because it is damaged. For example, there is the input-output damaged. So I can again export the configuration in a pen drive, for example, replace the controller and upload the application, plug again the pen drive and import back the configuration. So this is very easy and safe in C Suite, while it was more critical in OneTool. Well, that's all also regarding the default values.